Griz and Subtronics. Griztronics. I'm pumped about this one here.
What's up?
I just got one thing left to do.
Okay.
And this is it, just right here.
Oh shit.
We can't get enough. We can't get enough. DJ, run that shot there.
Ooh, this should be hitting different.
Oh, it's lit.
You guys not heard that before?
Oh, I've heard that.
Oh, definitely, bro. That track makes me want to do acid and get in a forest and get jiggy with some looks.
Get jiggy for sure.
I mean, that is like, that's definitely the last place I saw Subtronics live. So yeah, that makes sense. That was definitely, it was at a summer meltdown up here in Washington State. Great little tiny festival. Where like the camping is in a circle in the woods and fields around the main stage. And then the side stage is literally at the main stage. So you're like, watch this act. And then you turn and you watch that act. And then as soon as that ends, you go to the base tent, which is right next to that. And that's where I saw Subtronics play. And wow. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you rocked that one too.
That's some Wooksaw Supreme. I really feel like The strongest point of this track is like the catchiest little hook before the drop, and then a drop that actually delivers on that catchy hook's promise. Like, ooh, this shit be hitting different, and then you actually get some different sounding something when the beat kicks in. And then it kind of repeats its structure. But you never really get the same thing twice besides like some of the breakdown stuff. which is really nice, because when you have something that's that catchy, it's easy to just repeat it because you know people, like, you know that one's good already. But there was like four drops and they were all different.
Yeah, that, I mean, they had that. Some things that did repeat were like the way the groove moved you, the melody itself, that bum 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 bum. And then it would go bum 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 bum. It would do that over and over, but every time it did that, the patch felt different. The, you know, the context of it. And like, I loved how that, you know, that beginning part of the drop with that melody was like up, you know, real, you know, eighth note down up, like really, you know, kept my head moving up and down. And then it got into that faster part, but then that groove was kept up by the kick and the snare and the little like high pitched like eek sound on the upbeat. So it was like boom, eek, clack, eek, boom. You know, well, this faster rhythm was going on. And so like at no point do I stop banging my head. Like, I know we weren't on camera, but I was banging my head that whole time that you couldn't see me. I had to like fix my hair a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, most def.
Yeah, I really love exactly what you guys are bringing up here. It found the core essence of the track, what made it tick, had that little motif, had that checkerboard into the different, more minimal drop. You know, I see everybody in the chat talking about negative space. Like, they pulled that off so well, found out, all right, this is what makes the track tick. And then they just developed on that and didn't stray too far on that and did not try to make the track anything that it wasn't. You know, I think that's such a key aspect there. Like, once you get to a certain level in production, you're okay with not doing all of the things in every track. And I think it's important to reach that point sooner rather than later, because you're gonna, you know, you're gonna like water down the meaning of your tracks, even if there's not like a lyrical meaning. Like, you're gonna water down that motif, and the reason they could make it work, make four drops work that well, is because each one is an evolution off of the last, and you want to hear where this idea is going to go. It's like following a main character in a story. Like, it would make no sense, you know, if we're watching Spider-Man and then in the next scene he puts on the Batman costume and now he's doing Batman stuff, and then he's in the land of 300 like saying this is Sparta and kicking people down a hole. That's three different movies, but like, you know, there, how many Spider-Man movies have there been where it's like builds off that same concept, shows you different, and I guess I'm not talking about like the reworks, but you know what I mean? Like, let's say the old Peter Parker, the, what's his name? I can't remember right now, with the Green Goblin, right? They like build off that character. They show you that, how that character evolves, and you want to follow through with the story because there's something to contrast the character to. The fourth drop hits different because we could contrast it with three other drops prior, but it's the first drop and it's like minified version. It's like most simplest basic form that sets the forefront or the foreground for everything that's going to come after that.
Yeah.
Amen.
I don't know nothing about the Spider-Man universe, but I know the
producer. I feel like I butchered that.
The producer analogy is strong. Keep it to one movie, people. There can be an arc in your movie, but your movie needs consistent coloration and texture. It needs an arc that makes sense within itself, and it can't just divert here and there for no reason.
It also needs characters that build. Like inside of that arc, and each sound is a character. You know, some people play the background, some people play the foreground, some person is like the star of the show. But you got to make sure that if you're going to have a character get in a scary situation, you have to give a fuck about them first. So like, you know, build up who they are, give me that character, and then show them going through different things. Like, these sounds, they're not completely different sounds in each drop. They're the same, like, it's like the same patch with a different macro tweak. It's not a different patch that sounds completely disparate, and that helps tie everything together. It makes me want to hear, you know, you're getting the, what you want to hear in a way you haven't heard it yet. And that's important.
I like it.
What's up, humans? Yo, thanks so much for watching our reaction video. I'm Luke Rain from the Human Music Podcast. Please hit that subscribe, hit that like, comment. Let us know what videos you want to see us do in the future, or let us know what you thought of our breakdown of this one. And remember, we've got a whole podcast where we break down all sorts of producer and music related content. So tune in to the channel or check us out at thehumanmusicpodcast.com. All right, peace out, humans, and peace among worlds.